Hello friends, welcome to Learner's Planet. Friends, this is our sixth session for trigonometric functions. In the last session, we did good number of questions. In this session, we are going to take some more questions, a new pattern of questions. Okay, so just get ready with your paper and pen and start solving the problems with me. Now, let's take the first question for this session. Find x from the following equations. Okay, so cosec 90 plus theta, again, we have already discussed how to find this. See, cosec 90 plus theta, if you add something in 90 or deduct, then cosec will be converted to sec. So first of all, it is sec theta. Now cosec, and it is in second quadrant, right? 90 plus theta. So in second quadrant, cosec theta is positive. So I'll put a positive sign. So that's positive sec theta plus x cos theta cot 90 plus theta. Cot 90 plus theta, that means 10 theta, and now cot theta, it is in second quadrant, so it will be negative, so it will be negative 10 theta, so finally it is negative sign over here, is equal to sine 90 plus theta. So sine 90 plus theta will be cos theta, sine theta second quadrant, so it will be positive, so sine theta will sine 90 plus theta will be positive cos theta. Okay, now we have to find out the value of x. So what that will be? Sec theta minus cos theta upon cos theta into 10 theta, right? I take cos theta this side, and x cos theta 10 theta right hand side. Okay, so sec theta is 1 upon cos theta, and this is minus cos theta upon cos theta into sine theta by cos theta. Okay, so it is 1 minus cos square theta upon cos theta sine theta. Okay, and this cos theta and this cos theta will be cancelled. So this is the value of x. 1 minus cos square theta is sine square theta upon cos theta into sine theta, so precisely it is 10 theta. So what is the value of x? That is 10 theta, as simple as that. Now let's see this one. We have to prove that 10 720 cos 270 sine 150 cos 120 is 1/4. Okay, so 10 720, 720, that means two complete circles on horizontal line, so 10 theta will be 0, that means 10 720 will be 0. Cos 270, if I draw a circle over here, 270 will be there over here, right? So cos 270 will be 0. On this complete line, cos theta is 0, in this line sine theta is 0. So in this line sine theta is 0, that means 10 720 will also be 0, because 10 720 sine 720 by cos 720. So since sine 720 is 0, right, that is this line. Okay, so it is also 0. Sine 150, that is sine 90 plus 60 into cos 90 plus 30. Now sine 90 plus theta will be cos theta, but sine, it is in second quadrant, so it will be positive. So I put a positive sign over here, but it's negative sign, so I'll just take it as it is, right? Then into cos 90 plus theta, that is sine theta, but cos, and it is in second quadrant, right? So cos in second quadrant will be negative, so precisely it is minus sine 30 degree, so this minus and this minus will be plus. Now cos 60 is half and sine 630 is half, so it is 1/4, and that is a right hand side, right? So that's pretty simple. Now here, express each of the following as a sum of difference of sines and cosines. So we have the four relations. Sine a plus b is equal to, or I just take both of them together, sine a cos b plus minus cos a sine b, and cos a plus minus b is equal to cos a cos b minus plus sin a sin b. Now we take the first one, 2 sin 3 theta cos theta, that means 2 sin a cos b, right? So sin a cos b plus sin a cos b, that means sin a plus b and sin a minus b are added, right? This and sin a cos b plus cos a sin b and sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. So if you add both of them, you'll be getting 2 sin a cos b. So sin a plus b plus sin a minus b is equal to 2 sin a cos b. Though I have already explained you the derivation of this, sin a plus b plus sin a minus b is equal to 2 sin a cos b. Here a is 3 theta and b is theta. So I put up the value of a and b on both the sides. So sin a is 3 theta, b is theta. So it is 3 theta plus theta, 4 theta. Plus sin 3 theta minus theta, that is 2 theta, is equal to 2 sin 3 theta cos theta. So 2 sin 3 theta cos theta is sin 4 theta plus sin 2 theta. We have to express this as sum of difference of sines and cosines. So this is this. Okay. Similarly, you can calculate the other also. Suppose 2 cos theta, cos A cos B. Now 2 cos A cos B, that means cos A cos B plus cos A cos B, right? So if I have this cos A plus B and then I add cos A minus B, right? Cos A plus B plus cos A minus B, right? So what I'll be doing, cos A cos B minus sin A sin B plus cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So in that case, sin A sin B will be cancelled and we'll be getting 2 times cos A cos B. Okay, now put up the value of A and B, you'll be able to get this. Similarly, 2 sin A sin B. So for that, you first take cos A plus B and then deduct cos A minus B, right? So if you are going to deduct, cos A cos B will be cancelled and you'll be getting sin A sin B for 2 times. And 2 cos A sin B. So if you take sin A plus B, it is sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. And if you deduct sin A minus B from it, so you'll be getting sin A cos B minus cos A sin B. So sin A cos B will be cancelled, you'll be getting cos A, 2 cos A sin B. Okay, so this is how these sort of problems can be solved very easily. I hope you are getting me. Similarly, express each of the following as a product of sines and cosines. In the previous case, we have had to express as sum of sines and cosines. Over here, we have to express as product of sines and cosines. So just use these four formulae, right? Now, this is what sin A plus sin B. So sin A plus sin B. Just put up the value of A and B over here and you'll be getting the answer. So that's this, suppose I solve. It's 2 sin 12 plus 4, 16 by 2, so that's 8 theta. Cos 12 minus 4, 8 by 2, 4 theta. Okay? Similarly, you can solve other sums. Suppose, see over here, sin A minus sin B can be used. Here, cos A plus cos B can be used. Cos A minus cos B can be used. In this problem, it is sin A plus cos B, right? So we don't have formula for that, right? So this problem, how do we solve? Just see. So I just write it over here. Sin 2 theta plus cos 4 theta. So what you can do, you can write cos 4 theta in the terms of sin 4 theta. So how to write that? It is sin 90 minus 4 theta, right? Sin 90 minus theta is cos theta, right? And it is the first quadrant, so it will be positive. So sin 90 minus 4 theta is cos 4 theta. Now you have sin A plus sin B form. So sin A plus sin B, we can use this formula, right? So that is 2 sin 2 theta plus 90 minus 4 theta by 2, and then cos 2 theta minus 9 theta plus 4 theta by 2. Okay, so it is 2 sine 2 theta minus 90 minus 2 theta by 2, and this is cos 6 theta minus 90 by 2. Okay, now good number of students, what they do, they just cancel this and this. See, this is angle and this is the function, is the ratio is getting multiplied by 2. So this thing is different and this thing is different. It is not multiplication and division, so do not cancel them. That will be a blunder, a very big mistake, right? Over here it is, you can write it as 2 sine 45 minus theta, right? And here you can write 3 theta minus 45. Okay, so be very careful, do not do this. These two will never be cancelled. This is an angle and this is a trigonometric ratio getting multiplied by 2. So both the things are different. Okay. Now this sort of sums, though I have already explained you when we had to convert this into sum and difference of sines and cosines. Similar thing is there, 2 sine A sine B. Right, 2 sine A sine B. We can use this formula, though I have already explained you and you know the derivation. If you add sine A plus B and sine A minus B, 2 sine A cos B will be there, right? So 2 sine A sine B we want, so that is there, 2 sine A sine B. That means it is cos A minus B minus cos A plus B, right? So I do 2 sine A sine B. Here A is 5 pi by 12 and B is pi by 12. So put up the value over here. So 2 sine 5 pi by 12 and sine pi by 12 is equal to cos A minus B. Now cos A minus B, that means 5 pi minus 4 pi, that is 4 pi by 12, right? 5 pi minus pi by 12, so that is 4 pi by 12 minus cos A plus B, 5 pi plus pi, that is 6 pi by 12, right? So this is cos pi by 3 minus cos pi by 2. Cos pi by 3, that is cos 60 degree, that is half, and cos 90 is 0. So the value of this is half, and that only we had to prove. Right? So this is done. Now this is what? 2 cos A cos B. So 2 cos A cos B, this formula will be used for this. Then we have 2 sin A cos B. So 2 sin A cos B, use this formula. Right, so you have to do nothing extra, you just have to put up the value of A and B over here, right? A will be 5 pi by 12 and B will be pi by 12, that's it, nothing else you have to do. Okay, so you can do all these sums easily. Similarly, this pattern of problems, again you should be able to match up sine A plus sine B, right? Directly you can use this formula. I just do one for you. So it is 2 sine A plus B by 2. So 38 plus 22, that is 60 by 2, that is 30. Cos A minus B by 2. 38 minus 22, that is 16 by 2, that is 8. So sine 30 is half. So 2 into half into cos 8. Okay, so it is cos 8 degree. Now cos 8 is actually, it can be written as 90 minus 82, right? 90 minus 82 is 8. So cos 90 minus 82. Precisely 90 minus 82 is 8. So 8 can be written as 90 minus 82. Now cos 90 minus theta is what? Sin theta. Okay? So we are getting sin 82 over here. So this way it can be proved. Similarly, here cos A plus cos B. So this formula can be used. Right, sine A plus sine B, this formula can be used. Sine A plus sine B, sine A plus cos B. Now this is different, right? So what I can do is, it is sine 105 plus cos, I can write it as 90 plus 15. Now cos 90 plus theta is minus sine theta. Okay, now this it has been converted to sine A minus sine B. Now we can use this formula, right? So if both of them are not same, then you can convert one of them. Either you convert sine or you can convert cos. Suppose it is cos 105 over here. So it okay, I have done this. Here sine. So no problem, right? Easily you can do. So all these formulae we will be using again and again and again. And by using so many times, you'll be able to learn all these formulae. You'll be able to remember them also. Okay? Now, these sort of sums. Again, you can see cos A plus cos B, but there is cos C also, right? But we'll be using the same set of formula that we have used over here, but there is an extension, right? So, let's take the first one. Here, cos A plus cos B, right? So, cos A plus cos B is what? 2 cos A plus B by 2 cos A minus B by 2, right? So, I directly use the formula. For the first one, 2 cos A plus B by 2. So, 65 plus 55, that is 120 by 2, that is 60. Then cos A minus B by 2. So, 55 minus 65, that is minus 10 by 2. So, that is 5, right? Cos minus theta is cos theta only. Because cos minus theta is cos 0 minus theta, that means it is in fourth quadrant, so it will be cos theta only, positive. Okay, so it is cos 5 and now it is plus cos 175 degree. Okay, now cos 60 is what? 1 by 2. So this is 2 and this is 1 by 2. So they will be cancelled out. Finally, you are left with cos 5 plus cos 175. Now again, you can use cos A plus cos B formula. So that is 2 cos A plus B by 2, 175 plus 5, that is 180 by 2, 90, into cos A minus B by 2. So in case of cos, you do A minus B or minus B minus A, that really doesn't matter. So 175 minus 5, 170 by 2. But this cos 90 is 0, so this entire expression will be 0. Okay, so this is how you can solve these sort of problems very easily, simply, right? Similarly, suppose I take this sixth one. Now here, at one place we are having cos and other place we are having sine. So what we do, we can convert either sine to cos or cos to sine. Now cos pi by 12, I can write it as sine pi by 2 minus pi by 12. It's in first quadrant, so that value will be positive only, and minus sine pi by 12, right? So this is sine A minus sine B. Sine pi by 2 minus theta is cos theta, so this is actually conversion of cos pi by 12. So cos pi by 12 can be written as like this. Now this is sine A minus sine B. Now what is the formula for sine A minus sine B? That is 2 cos A plus B by 2 and sine A minus B by 2. So I write over here 2 cos pi by 2 minus pi by 12 plus pi by 12 by 2 into sine pi by 2 minus pi by 12 minus pi by 12 by 2. Okay, so it is 2 cos. Now pi by 12 is cancelled. Pi by 2 is pi by 4, and this is sine pi by 2 minus this is 2 pi by 12, that means pi by 6. So precisely it is pi by 2 minus pi by 6. Okay, so sine pi by 2 minus pi by 6 and by 2, so it is pi by 4 minus, or you can do, you can calculate it, just a moment. Here it is pi by 2 or pi by 2 minus pi by 6. So it is 3 pi minus pi, 2 pi by 6 and divided by 2, right? This 2. So precisely it is pi by 6. So sine pi by 6. So 2 into cos pi by 4 is cos 145. It is 2 into 1 by root 2. Sine pi by 6 is sine 30, that is 1 upon 2. So precisely it is 1 by root 2. Just be careful in solving this. Pi by 2 minus pi by 6 by 2. So pi by 2 minus pi by 6 you need to solve, and then you have to divide it by 2. Again, this 2 and this 2 will not be cancelled. Be very careful about it. Right? So similarly, you can solve other problems also. Right? Here cos 81 can be written as sine 9. Now you can use the formula of sine A plus sine B. Right? So friends, I think that's enough for this session. We'll take some more problems, some more patterns in this topic. And do revise this session in the previous ones. Bye-bye.